Hey, what's going on, everybody? Chad Christian coming at you with another exciting video. Today, I'm bringing you the review of the MacBook Pro 15. This is the space gray edition with the touch bar. I'm also going to show you a comparison and a side-by-side with the 13-inch base model and the 13-inch with the touch bar. So let's get into the hardware specs. The 15-inch base model that I have here comes with a 2880 by 1800 Retina display, a 2.6 gigahertz quad core Intel Core i7 processor with turbo boost up to 3.5 gigahertz, 16 gigs of DDR3 RAM, a 256 gig PCIe SSD, which is the fastest SSD I've ever tested, has a Radeon Pro 450 with 2 gigs of DDR5 memory from AMD, and the integrated processor is an Intel HD Graphics 530. Now the 13-inch base model without the touch bar that I have here is a 2 GHz system with a dual core i5, 8 gigs of RAM, 256 gig SSD, and this one has the Intel Iris Graphics 540. Now the 13-inch base model with the touch bar that I have here is a 2.9 GHz dual core Intel i5, which turbo boosts up to 3.3 GHz, 8 gigs of RAM, 256 gig PCIe SSD, and the Intel integrated Iris Graphics 550 versus the 540. So you can see right away with the 13-inch models, you're gonna get the Intel Core i5, which is just a dual core processor, or if you bump up to that 15-inch, you're gonna get a quad core with an i7, so it's a much faster processor. One thing to note with the 13-inch base model without the touch bar is you only get two USB-C ports, and with all of the versions, whether it's 13 or 15-inch, it comes with four USB-C ports. And all of these ports are Thunderbolt 3. Now for the sake of comparing them, I'm just going to use the base model 13 against the 15-inch model. So the 13-inch is a 3-pound or 14.9 millimeters in weight, and the 15 is 4 pounds and 15.5 millimeters in weight. You can see that the 13-inch is a lot smaller dimension-wise. The height's only 0.6 inches or 1.49 centimeters. The width is 12 inches or 30 centimeters, and the depth is 8 inches and 21 centimeters. Now the 15-inch model is almost the same in height, that's 0.61 inches or 1.55 centimeters. The width is 13.75 inches or 35 centimeters, and the depth is 9.5 inches or 24 centimeters. And both the 13 and 15-inch model use the 720p FaceTime camera. Now as far as battery life goes, Apple is claiming 10 hours on both the 13 and the 15, and I'm getting anywhere from 8 to 9 hours with light to medium type work. Obviously if I'm doing a lot of video editing or gaming or professional style work, you know, photo editing, I'm going to lower that to around 5 or 6 hours. Now let's continue to look further around the unit. On the very bottom here we've got our four bottom feet plus our ventilation system that you can see is on the bottom there. So instead of it facing up to the display like the previous models, the exhaust is out of the bottom and the sides of the unit. Now one thing to note with the sides of the unit is it has this extremely sharp edge, and I think you need to be careful when you're carrying it, which also could be an issue I think with things getting stuck in there. So we'll have to wait and see on that as time goes on. Now as far as the sound system goes, this is the best sound system on any laptop. So let's do a quick test here for you.
Display is a 2560 by 1600, 227 ppi and 500 nits of brightness, so it gets plenty bright. This model has 8 gigs of RAM, they're DDR3, 256 gig PCIe based SSD, which is incredibly fast. It also has an Intel Iris Graphics 550, which is a bump.
So if you want a nice full sound system, the 15 is the way to go. The 13 actually sounds really nice too. It is really loud, it's just not as full. Now let's talk about this trackpad. Holy supersize me, right? This is the bad boy. This is the biggest trackpad I've ever seen in my life before. And do I like it? Yeah, I actually love it. It's easier to do your gestures, you know, your four fingers, three finger gestures. Everything is a little bit easier. You can see just how large it is. That's an iPhone 7 Plus, and it's still bigger than that. Now it does have the haptic feedback system instead of the old diving board spring hinge system. So this is the same as they had last year, which I really appreciate. I think it's a good system. Now let's talk about the keyboard. This is a butterfly 2.0 style system with 0.5 millimeters in travel, and it is a little more clicky, which I like. So you can hear it here. So it does feel a little better on the hands. I actually prefer this over last year's, and I think I'm gonna like this more than the old previous keyboards. Now let's talk about that Touch ID sensor. You can see here when I open the lid, it says to unlock with Touch ID. You can just push your finger down on that. Now, one thing to note with the new Mac OS Sierra and the watch, Apple Watch system, is you can unlock your system using your Apple Watch as well. And I'll show you how to do that in a minute. So if you want to set up the Touch ID, you just go into Settings, click on Touch ID. You can see here that I've already have a fingerprint added, but you can add additional fingers to it. So let's go ahead and add our finger. And after putting in my password, you just lift your finger and touch the ID sensor multiple times. It's just like setting it up for your iPhone. It's really fast, it's convenient, it's accurate. This does allow you to use Apple Pay and iTunes to purchase things. But the funny thing is you can't use it to log in like for websites, which would be really cool if you could do that like Microsoft has, or any of your system apps. If you want to unlock system settings, you still have to key in your password. I wish you could use your Touch ID. So hopefully on some updates, they'll allow you to do that. Now, like I was saying before, if you want to unlock this with your phone or with your watch, just go to Settings, General, and allow your Apple Watch to unlock your Mac. So this is cool. It's faster. It's more convenient than using the Touch ID sensor. So you can see here, if I open up the lid, it's going to automatically unlock my system now. Now let's talk about the cool feature of the year, the touch bar. As you can see here, I'm using the touch bar to control the brightness up and down. So I've got the extended touch bar out there. That isn't the default. It's usually set just like this. There you are with the slide bar, which you can either slide it or you can just tap on it. So that's really cool. So now I'm going to use it with the app so you can see how the OLED bar actually changes depending on which app you're using. So it is customizable to the programmers. So you can see I've got the photo apps open, and if I want, I can quickly scroll through the images just by swiping on the touch bar. And it is a glass touch bar, so it feels really nice. Very smooth, responsive, no glitches. It's extremely fast. I mean, the second you touch it, it's working. Now, this is how you can actually edit your work. So you can see here, if I click on the filters button, all the different filters pop up. So it feels like you're using your iPad Pro, which is really cool. So if I want now, I can swipe my finger over and it will filter instantly on screen, as you can see there. Yeah, of course you could use your mouse or touchpad and you could click on it, but something about the instant response of touching on it it's great. So if we can't get a touchscreen, I'm happy that they've at least included this. So another supported app right now is the mail system. So you can see when I have my mail open that again, the OLED bar changes. So you can see I can instantly forward messages. I can move messages. It still has my full-time Siri up there. And all of these are customizable, which is really cool. And I'll show you how to do that later. But this is pretty neat. If I want to, I can just quickly change those things. If I want, I can move it to different folders right on the fly. So really your menu system has changed. It's pretty intuitive. It's easy to use. I hope programmers take advantage of it so it's not just the Apple apps. Final Cut Pro works fantastic too for trimming and sound volume and scrubbing. It works really well. Now if you want to change the default settings that are in the touch bar, you just go to Settings, Keyboard, and you can see under the keyboard where you can use your the touch bar settings of which ones you want to show. So extended control strip, so now you can see your normal, what your old function keys used to be on there. Now if you want, you can customize this even further by just dragging and dropping anything that you want inside of the toolbar here. So I do a lot of dictation, and normally I have it set to double press my function key to turn it on, but now I can just permanently leave it on there, and when I click done, you can see that it's just going to stay permanent now. Now you can just hold your function key to get your function row back up there on the top. So it is available if you need it. So the big question of the day is, which one should you get? Well, I think if you're a student on a budget or you just use this for extremely light casual use, I would go with the base model without the touch bar, because you are paying a premium to get the touch bar and the higher spec model. So if you're a medium professional user, let's say you do some light photo editing, you do some video editing, you're just not doing it all the time or on a daily basis, then, and you want portability, I'd go with a 13 inch with a touch bar. Has a higher spec bump, a little bit faster integrated Intel graphics processor. But if you need the bad boy, you need the horsepower, you're a daily user, you know, you do weddings, videography stuff daily, you're a programmer, you need the 16 gigs of RAM, the quad core processor. Or if you're a gamer, yes, you can do gaming. So make sure you guys watch future videos, because I am going to do some gaming segments with this system. Then I would for sure be looking at the 15 inch model. Well, that's going to do it for my video today. I hope you guys enjoyed it. If you did, hit that thumbs up. Make sure you subscribe for more videos like this. And if you have any comments or suggestions, make sure to leave them down below. And I'll see you guys on the next video.